Variables are data storage space for numeric or string values. The string is basically text. The main benefit of using variables instead of directly using the data themselves is that we can reuse them by calling the variable names when needed. Variable names are typically English alphabet, A to Z, either lowercase or uppercase, or combinations of English alphabet, numeric number, and underscore. Here are a couple of examples for creating variables. In this diagram, my English alphabet A is a variable name, and numeric number 2 is the numeric number that I would like to save in the data storage space. I can use B1 as a variable name to hold a numeric number 3. Next, I can use a underscore text as a single word for a variable name to hold octave as string or text values. Let's practice how to create variables. Here is a basic rule to follow to create the variables. First, you need to start with the variable name followed by equal sign. Then type expression afterwards. The expression can be either a numeric number, mathematical expression, string, and another variables, or combinations of them. For example, to create a variable A to hold the number 2, you should type A equal sign followed by 2 and hit enter in the command window. If successfully created, it automatically prints A equals 2 below. If you don't want to immediately print, you can use the semicolon at the end of expression, such as A equal to 3 followed by semicolon at the end. So you don't see any result in the screen, but it creates the variable A internally. You can check what data has been saved by simply typing A followed by enter key. If you try to print the variable name that has not been created before, you will get the error message. For example, if you simply type B, which never been used before, and you get an error message as undefined. Octave cannot print the undefined variable. You can also a mathematical expression to create a variable. I would like to create a variable B to assign the result of 1 plus 3 over 2. Type B equals sign followed by 1 plus 3 divided by 2. You can create a variable C by assigning the data given in the existing variable B. To do this, type C equals sign followed by B. Also, you can create a variable D by adding 1 to the existing variable B. To run this operation, you can type D equals sign followed by B plus 1. You can use the same variable in the left and right sides of equal sign, just like A equals to A plus 1. The A on the left side of the equal sign is considered as a new variable name even though you already had it. The A on the right hand side is considered as the expression. Basically, this expression is translated as we create the variable A by assigning A plus 1. In this case, we already have 3 in the variable A and we add 1 to 3 to update the variable A with 4. In other words, we replace A on the left side with 4. This expression is very useful to replace it by itself without creating a new variable when we write a code in the future. So please keep in mind. So far, we created 4 variables, A through D. To check what variable names has been used so far, there are a couple of different ways. First, we can simply type who, WHO. You can see the list of variables that has been created so far. We have A through D and ANS. You can also type whose, add S at the end to check some more details including the data size, memory use, and precision. You can also check the workspace on the left side of the main window. It shows the variable names and given data. To delete the variable, you can use clear followed by the variable names that you want to delete. For example, you can clear variables A and B by typing clear space A space B. Check it in the workspace or type who. See what happened. You can also delete all the variables using clear all. There are a few things that you need to be careful about variable names. First, the variable name must not include special characters or any empty space. For example, A exclamation mark BC does not work because of exclamation mark. A space BC cannot be used because of space between A and B. 1 ABC does not work either since you cannot start with the number for the variable name. Variable names are case sensitive and ABC, all lowercase, is different from ABC with the uppercase A. So you need to be careful about this. To create the variable name for text, you should use single quotation mark. Your text should be enclosed by two single quotation mark. For example, you can create a underscore text for Octave. Without using the single quotation mark, you will get the error. It says undefined, meaning that it considers Octave as a variable name, but it has not been used before, so it gives us an error. In summary, you have learned about variables focusing on single element. Thanks for watching this video, and please subscribe my channel if you haven't done it yet. Thumbs up if you enjoyed. Please feel free to share your thoughts in the comment section below. See you next time.